Greetings from the Beach Hut. This is a Postman Cometh, and this particular Postman Cometh is about samples or products that I've gotten through subservices and then decided to repurchase in fuller size. I'll start with some skincare and body products and move on to makeup. First of all, never figured out how to say this. MBEZ, M-B-E-Z-E. These are little deodorants. I had one in Coco Haze. I think I got it in my goodie box. Loved it. Traveled with it. Thought it smelled amazing. Katie from Naturella Beauty tweeted me and said, hey, there's a Groupon. And I went, oh, yes, Groupon. And it was kind of a two-for-one special. So this is the scent Twice Shy. I don't like it as well as Coco Haze, but I like it a lot. And you did have to get two of them, and I have two more coming in a different scent. It's a funny thing about Groupons, you know, sometimes they come really quickly, sometimes they come really slowly. These came really, really fast, still waiting on the other. I assume they come from different places. The next thing I picked up was this African Botanics Marulia, Pure Marulia Oil. I got this in a Beauty Sage box. The Sun Box, and fell in love with it. Another one I traveled with and thought, oh my God, really, really love this. This was pricey. I think it's $80. But I was able to get a coupon. I got 20 or 25% off, and I bit the bullet. Really loved it. Loved the smell of it. Loved the way it worked, but particularly loved the smell of it. And yes, I know I can get other marulia oils for less, but I felt like this one was worth it. Oh, love, love, love the smell of it. And there is nothing in here but marulia oil. They have found the best little marulia oil around. This next product either came from an indie style box or perhaps from the Natural Beauty box, because the Natural Beauty box at the last minute kind of shifted and sent a bunch of Etsy products. I didn't do an opening of those. I'm not sure why I got those. I wasn't expecting to get those Natural Beauty boxes, but there were two of them and they were filled with Etsy product. One of the products in there was Herbalution Chamomile and Calendula Facial Cleansing Grain. Now this one actually comes from Artfire as opposed to Etsy. And it was a little face food, almost like what you would get from the All Natural Face. This does have baking soda in it. Gave it a shot, and I liked it, and I love having the face foods around. It is right now how I'm cleansing my face at night. I take one of my face foods, love the ones from the All Natural Face. I'm using strawberries and cream, peaches and cream, or orange and cream. I also love Brand New Day from One Love Organics. All of these are dry cleansing, exfoliating products that you can add to other things and make really intriguing masks and treatments. I use them every night to cleanse. I put a bit of that powder in there. I put in some argan or marulia oil, and then I put in some honey. I mix it all up. I put it on my face for about 5 or 10 minutes. Usually I watch a YouTube video, and then I take it off. I wet it and take it off with my Clarisonic. Before that, I do remove all my makeup, and right now I'm using the Celtic Complexion coconut cleanser to do that. But I love these things. I thought, well, this would be a nice little addition to my face food collection, because I like just kind of going in there and, you know, what will I use tonight? Each one addresses a slightly different thing. I went to go get it and I saw they had a bunch more, so then I couldn't choose. So I had to get samples. This is chocolate polish and mask. This is lemon cleanser. This is raspberry cleanser. They call this facial breakfast. And this is rose hibiscus. And then there is another little package here. Okay, this is some more facial cleansing grains. This one is sandalwood, spicy pumpkin, rosemary, cinnamon and clove. Holy cow, there's a lot of them. Peppermint and sage. Lemon verbena and lemongrass, patchouli, lavender, chamomile and calendula. That's the one I tried. I'll probably end up picking one or two of these from Herbalutions up in the full side to add to my face food collection. They also had a facial herbal steam product. This is something that you add to boiling water and hang your head over with a towel. I usually will put something on my face first. I'm using a product from Shea Terra that is no longer available on their website, but this is something that you can make the little tea to kind of enrich that experience a little bit more. Another thing I picked up from Herbalutions while I was picking up samples, I am almost out of sugar scrubs, so I wanted to get those. And so I picked up two of these. This is the coconut vanilla fudge. One of these, I noticed, this is a sugar scrub. And this one, this body polish, is a raspberry sorbet with cocoa. And this one is actually a sugar and salt scrub. So, yikes. I'm not supposed to be using the salt scrubs because my husband is convinced that they ruin the pipes. Don't know whether he's right or wrong, but I try to stick with the sugar. So I didn't pay close enough attention, and this one is a combined sugar and salt scrub. But I have these two to try. The one disappointment I had, I wanted to try their toners, and they had a cucumber breeze and a rose bloom. One is called flower water, and the other is called facial toner. Good. The samples were $1.50, fine, but here's the size. If you can see, they're teeny tiny vials. I'm not sure I'll be able to even have a sense of whether these work or not. So I was a little disappointed in this particular sample size because I just don't think I'm going to be able to appraise anything based on something this tiny. But very, very happy with the face food samples and with the sugar scrub sample, and looking forward to trying the herbal steam. So that was kind of my sample selection that I got from Herbalution. I should say that the shipping on it was rather high. I think it was like $12 shipping, and I almost took it out of the cart. I was like, well, I'm not paying $12 for shipping, but I went ahead and did it. And then for some reason I got an $8 rebate, and I'm not sure why. From my good eBox recently, I received a certified organic brow pencil. This is in Blonde Bombshell. I had to have another one of these, and so there was a sale. I went ahead and picked it up. I think I got this from the Derm store. While I was there, I went ahead and picked up their organic eyeliner in cocoa. I'm looking for a brown eyeliner that I can tightline with. The last place that I shopped from was someplace called the Pure Boutique. I had received Pure Anatta pigments in my Natural Beauty box when it was kind of in its original incarnation. And I liked them, but the shipping to go from Canada to the U.S. is just crazy. You would think you were crossing the three oceans. It's Canada. It's North America. It's right there. What's the deal here? Sorry, I digress. The Pure Boutique has some decent shipping on the Pure Anatta products, and in this case, it was like free shipping if you purchase so much. So I went to the clearance and I got some things. Pure Anatta has these pressed pigments, which you often don't see. You often don't see the natural pressed pigments because normally to press them, they're going to add in either the silicones or zinc stearate, which is an irritant. And even some plain pigments will have the zinc stearate in them. But I saw these and these looked good to me. One is called Nectar and the other is called Grape, and they were on sale. What's interesting about these Press Shadows by Pure Anatta is that they're not using either the silicones or the zinc stearate as the pressing medium. It looks like they're using jojoba oil. So I'm excited to try those. These little palettes were also on sale for $2.50 or something like that. And I needed some of these, and I like the size because they're not big and this folds over. So I picked up some of these. While I was there, I just picked up some extra loose pigments. You can see there's quite a few. They have these little sample packs. You just pick the colors that you want, and then they tied them all in a little ribbon so that they're very handy. Who knows? I like to travel with these, so I might use these when I go to Portugal, or I might use Meow Cosmetics, or I might use both, because really, that's so small. The last thing I picked up from Pure Anatta was their eyeliner in Pure Line Brown. You can see I'm like a dog with a bone right now. I'm about to finish using up my dark brown eyeliner. It's in my Makeout 2013. It's not a clean product. It's a product I used to tightline with, and I need to replace it with another dark brown pencil. And so I'm trying to look for something that I would like. So I have the Inica product to try, and then I have the Carinata product to try, and I'll probably be trying others. So that is it for my samples I received for my subservices that I have purchased more of. The biggest by far was Marulia oil. I can't believe it. I thought and thought and thought, do I want to do this? Do I want to do this? Do I want to do this? Got the good percentage off, 20, 25%, and now have this. Really like that product. Really like these little deodorants. The only thing that would have stopped me from picking up these deodorants was the price. So when the Groupon came around, yes, wanted those. Herbalution, I've just become this kind of face food junkie, and I thought, oh, that's interesting. I'll try some other face foods, and I needed sugar scrubs. And then the brow pencil from Inica. Like it. So easy to use. One swipe. Perfect color. The only thing I don't like about this brow pencil, this blonde bombshell, is that it gets used up fast. I mean, I'm already feeling like I'm probably halfway done with the one I received, and I'm used to those kinds of things lasting a little bit longer, so I'm a little stunned that I can imagine it will probably last 2 months, and that's it. Other than that, I liked it a great deal. And lastly, of course, the Pirinata shadows that I wanted to try, those fresh shadows with the jojoba oil, and I'll get back and let you know how those go. As always, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you're up to. I had that moment of panic. The closer it gets to the 15th of July, that means that I just have 1 month left at the beach. Summer is just racing away from me. At this point, I have to kind of pull myself back and go, just appreciate the time you have left at the beach instead of going, oh no, only this much left, only this much left. Yeah, I'm the kind of person who could, you know, be an Eeyore kind of, yeah, my vacation's almost over. Instead of like, poo, jolly, happy, I still have another month of vacation before I have to go back to school. So I'm going to hold that happy thought. I hope you will hold your happy thoughts and make it a great, great day. Bye.